We have come together in the name of Christ to offer our praise and thanksgiving, to hear and receive God's holy word, to pray for the needs of the world, and to seek the forgiveness of our sins, that by the power of the Holy Spirit we may give ourselves to the service of God. Jesus says, "Repent, for the kingdom of heaven is close at hand." So let us turn away from our sin and turn to Christ, confessing our sins in penitence and faith. Lord God, we have sinned against you and have done evil in your sight. We are sorry and repent. Have mercy on us according to your love. Wash away our wrongdoing and cleanse us from our sin. Renew a right spirit within us and restore us to the joy of your salvation. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. May the Father of all mercies cleanse us from our sins and restore us in his image to the praise and glory of his name. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. The night has passed, and the day lies open before us. Let us pray with one heart and mind. As we rejoice in the gift of this new day, so may the light of your presence, O God, set our hearts on fire with love for you, now and forever. Amen. A reading from the book of Revelation. After this I looked, and there was a great multitude that no one could count, from every nation, from all tribes and peoples and languages, standing before the throne and before the Lamb, robed in white with palm branches in their hands. They cried out in a loud voice, saying, "Salvation belongs to our God, who is seated on the throne, and to the Lamb." And all the angels stood around the throne, and around the elders, and the four living creatures, and they fell on their faces before the throne, and worshipped God, singing, "Amen. Blessing and glory and wisdom, and thanksgiving and honour, and power and might, be to our God, for ever and ever. Amen." Then one of the elders addressed me, saying, "Who are these, robed in white, and where have they come from?" I said to him, "Sir, you are the one that knows." Then he said to me, "These are they who have come out of the great ordeal. They have washed their robes and made them white in the blood of the Lamb. For this reason, they are before the throne of God, and worship him day and night within his temple. And the one who is seated on the throne will shelter them. They will hunger no more, and thirst no more. The sun will not strike them, nor any scorching heat. For the Lamb at the centre of the throne will be their shepherd, and he will guide them to springs of the water of life. And God will wipe away every tear from their eyes." This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
A reading from Matthew's Gospel. When Jesus saw the crowds, he went up the mountain, and after he sat down, his disciples came to him. Then he began to speak and taught them, saying, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the earth. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be filled. Blessed are the merciful, for they will receive mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. Blessed are those who are persecuted for righteousness' sake, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when people revile you and persecute you and utter all kinds of evil against you falsely on my account. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward is great in heaven. For in the same way they persecuted the prophets who were before you. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
So today is November the 1st, and this is when we celebrate the Feast of All Saints. So I want to ask you a couple of questions. What do you think a saint is, and what do you think we're actually celebrating today? Now, if you Google All Saints, you get a mixture of information, mostly about a 1990s pop group. And I do have to say, I did find a very fine new clothes shop online. If you dig deeper, you find a number of churches which are called All Saint. But none of the above really answers the question we're asking. What do we think a saint is, and what is it that we are doing today? What are we giving thanks for? Now, the old English word for a saint is hallow, which simply means to honour as holy. So saints are people we honour as holy. Now, the night before All Hallows Day is All Hallows Eve, or as it's commonly known now, Halloween. Now, I have to say this date has varied throughout history and across traditions. Today, we celebrate All Saints Day, as I've said, on the 1st of November, mainly due to Pope Gregory IV. He moved the date of this festival in the Middle Ages to coincide with Samhallein, a pagan festival of the dead observed by the ancient Celts, in an attempt to assimilate and replace existing pagan calendar dates with Christian celebrations. Now, that's one possible explanation of the expressions of Halloween that we see today. Now, many would see Halloween as harmless fun. Personally, I'm a little uncomfortable with that, because for me, Halloween is the opposite of what All Hallows Eve is about. It has become a celebration of darkness, which is often translated into fantasy fun. Vampires, witches, Frankenstein's monster and the like. Now, we all know that there is real darkness in the world. Murder, war, sickness, child abuse, death. Real darkness, real evil. And for that reason, I find myself unable to celebrate Halloween. But I can and I do celebrate All Hallows Eve, a night to remember and celebrate the saints of God. But this brings us back to my first question. What do we think a saint is? So, what does the Bible say? That's always the best place to start, I find. Now, the original Christian meaning, the New Testament usage of the word, means any believer in Christ and in whom Christ dwells, in heaven or on earth. So, in other words, alive or dead. Now, the Testament usage does not actually denote specific Christians of great virtue, but rather the living faithful. So, Paul often starts his letters by writing to the saints. So, he writes to the saints in Rome, to the saints in Corinth, to the saints in Ephesians, Ephesians 1 verse 1, Paul, an apostle of Jesus Christ, by the will of God, to the saints which are at Ephesus, and to the faithful in Christ Jesus. Anyone you know who loves Jesus is a saint of God, and that includes you. So as we celebrate All Hallows Eve, All Saints Day, and All Souls Day, which follows, we do so in the fundamental belief that there is a prayerful spiritual bond between those in heaven and the living. So to be a Christian is to belong to a very large family. This is not a solitary pursuit. Through belief, faith, and baptism, We become and remain members of one another in Jesus. As soon as we put our faith in Jesus, we become members of a company of saints whose mutual belonging transcends many things. It transcends culture. We are as connected to another Christian in Tampere or Lahore as we are to any Christian in Manchester. It transcends denomination. I'm as connected to a Baptist in India, or an Episcopate in America, as I am to the Bishop of Manchester. It transcends doctrine, dogma, custom, ritual tradition, and even death. Even death. The point of All Saints' Day is to remember and to celebrate the breadth and the depth of the Christian believing family, the vast cloud of witnesses that surrounds us, the huge family to which we belong. Now, we're familiar with the notable and the famous. St. Matthew, Mark, Luke, or John, St. Paul, or St. Thomas, or St. Augustine. And these people are rightly remembered and honoured. But All Saints' Day is about so much more than that. It's about remembering and giving thanks for the entire host of Christian believers. I sometimes think that if we concentrate too much on the great and the good, the idea of sainthood becomes disconnected from us. It becomes so distant and unattainable. The danger is that we don't so much take encouragement from the saints of the past as feel inferior to them, unable to match their faith or their great virtue. And in so doing, we forget the all-important grace of God and the power at work in us through the Holy Spirit. So I want to encourage you to look around you, to your brothers and sisters in Christ. They are the saints of God. You are a saint of God, a believing Christian, a saint in the New Testament sense of the word. Now, it's of course right to look for inspiration from the lives of saints of the past. I mean, who do you look to? Perhaps one of the great Christian fathers, perhaps Origen or Augustine. Maybe Thomas Aquinas or Martin Luther, John Calvin. Perhaps modern-day saints like Mother Teresa or great writers like C.S. Lewis. Now, the ones I connect with will be totally unknown to you. They are the ones that I've connected with through my life, who have shaped my Christian life because of the way that they have lived overcoming and faithful Christian lives through the normal everyday challenges. Their lives have inspired and guided me. I think of my Pathfinder leaders who very patiently put up with me and taught me who Jesus was through welcome, acceptance, and great love. I think of my youth group leader, and truthfully, he was called John Wayne. Honestly, John Wayne. He spoke to me about the love of Jesus, about his sacrifice, the gift of life he offered me. And then he introduced me to Jesus. I think of my pastor at the Elim Church in Derby that we attended for 13 years, who taught us how to grow deeper in Christ and modelled for us how to be a true shepherd of the sheep. I think of the curate Mike in Derby, who allowed me to flourish in my own leadership, allowed me to explore where God was taking me, helping me to say yes to God's call on my life. And there have been many, many others. You will have people in your past too, whom I will never know or recognise. These people testify to the fact that Christ is in all and over all, and dwells most importantly in the ordinary everyday circumstances and challenges of life, not just in the big issues or the great movements of the church, or the notable names of the canonized. Most of life is ordinary. Most of the 7 billion people who live today live ordinary. But magnificent, overcoming lives and make the world what it is. So what is a saint? Living, dead, global, local, well-known, unknown. These are the saints. These are the saints we give thanks for today. These are our brothers and sisters in Christ. So today we praise God for his grace and his provision, for each bearer of his light and love, and that includes you and me. May we be all that he wants us to be, by his power and for his glory and for the sake of the world. Amen.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
United in the company of all the faithful and looking for the coming of the kingdom, let us offer our prayers to God, the source of all life and holiness. Inspired by the vision of a great multitude that no one could count, from every nation, from all tribes and peoples and languages, let us pray for the church throughout the world. Remembering that these are they who have come out of the great ordeal, pray for Christians being targeted for murderous attacks. This week, the World Council of Churches asks us to pray for the church in Polynesia, thousands of small islands scattered across the Pacific Ocean. In our own city, pray for God's blessing on Bishop David and Bishop Mark. Pray for our own Reverend Mark and his team here at St. Chad's, asking God's blessing on our future online services and prayerful use of our building. May we and all who minister be built on the foundation of the apostles and prophets into a holy temple in the Lord. Lord, in your mercy,
hear
our prayer. Jesus tells us that blessed are the peacemakers. Let us pray for peacemakers and peacekeepers, and join with Sabeel, longing for peace in the Holy Land. Remember the people of Izmir, struggling with the aftermath of the severe earthquake. Close to home, pray for those with responsibility for implementing this new lockdown. Pray that sound advice will be both given and taken, and people comply with the protective measures. The writer of Revelation looks forward to a time when people will hunger no more and thirst no more. The sun will not strike them, nor any scorching heat. Pray for the millions of displaced people living in refugee camps, where this is far from true. Pray and give thanks for Christian aid and all working to change this. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. In the midst of gloom and apprehension, let us rejoice in the vitality of our city and community. Give thanks and pray for our councillors and the council staff who serve this area. Pray for teachers and school staff anxiously preparing to return to local schools in a deeply unwelcome and unexpected new environment. Remember those who provide us with daily essentials. Help keep everyone safe and healthy. Tend parks and gardens, and in a thousand ways support our communal life. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer.
Giving thanks for the dedicated work of the NHS, we ask for your healing touch for all those who are unwell, at home or in hospital. We remember particularly those suffering from COVID-19 and those facing delays to diagnosis and treatments as a result of the pandemic. We pray for those suffering from anxiety, for those with huge financial worries, those going hungry, and those who are homeless. We remember those who have asked for our prayers, asking that you be their healer, comfort and protection. We ask that they will be comforted by our prayers and help them all to trust in your unfailing love. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayers.
We commend into your hands all those who have recently died, remembering those who loved and cared for them and those who mourn their loss. We pray for the soul of Vilma Ramat Masai, who died in India on Friday. And from our remembrance book, the souls of Harold Rylott, Alfred Garner, Leslie Jones and Doreen Doody, whose anniversaries fall this week. And as we move in our worship today between All Saints and All Souls, we give thanks this morning for all those we have loved but are no longer with us, but remain in our hearts. May they rest in peace and rise in glory. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
May Christ, who makes saints from sinners, who has transformed those we remember today, strengthen us and all faithful people, that we may help to transform the world. And so, rejoicing in the fellowship of St. Chad, St. Nicholas, and the whole company of saints, we commend ourselves and the whole of creation to your unfailing love. Merciful Father,
accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Almighty God, you have knit together your elect in one communion and fellowship, in the mystical body of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Grant us grace so to follow your blessed saints in all virtuous and godly living, that we may come to those inexpressible joys that you have prepared for those who truly love you. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Let us pray as our Saviour has taught us. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. And so may the peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep our hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God, and of his Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Amen. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. In the name of Christ. Amen.